Now, Harry, whence come you?
My noble lord, from Eastcheap!
Huzzah!
My blood hath been too cold and temperate. You tread upon my patience.
Our house, my sovereign liege, little deserves a scourge of greatness to be used on it.
Worcester, get thee gone, for I do see danger and disobedience in thine eye.
All studies here I solemnly defy, save that a gall and pinch this bowling brook,
and that same sword and buckler Prince of Wales, but that I think his father loves him not and would be glad he met with some mischance.
I see riot and dishonor stain the brow of my young Harry.
Douglas and the English rebels met the 11th of this month at Shrewsbury.
Some heavy business hath my lord in hand, and I must know it, else he loves me not.
What sayest thou, my lady? What wouldst thou have with me?
Do you not love me? Stirred thee in thy sleep, that beads of sweat have stood upon thy brow like bubbles in a late disturbed stream.
So when this loose behavior I throw off, and pay the debt I never promise it, by how much better than my word I am?
Percy, Northumberland, Douglas, Glendower, Mortimer, capitulate against us in our hut. But wherefore do I tell these news to thee?
I so offend to make offense a skill.
I was as virtuously given as a gentleman need to be. Now I live out of all order, out of all comfort. Why, you are so fat, Sir John. You must needs be out of all compass. Out of all reasonable compass, Sir John. Do thou amend thy face, and I'll amend my life. Can honor set to a leg? No. Or an arm? No. Or take away the grief of a wound? No.
Day be bold to tell you that I am your son.
What is in that word?